we're gonna press on. Tenchu is in the process of punching a zombie to the jaw. So, oh, yeah. Tenchu, oh, yeah. Boy.
So, rolling, I get a 21.
Yeah, yeah. That's, yeah, that hits.
So, that is 6 damage. And I'm gonna bonus action to attack again. That's 14.
Yeah, bolt hit.
So, another 6 damage. Total of 12 damage.
You, you know, one to the jaw, his jaw dislocates. Another one, you punch his jaw clean off. Flies through the oak. He looks very upset. Roll initiative, please. Also, for people watching, Ian / Rizbit / our original streamer is going through technical difficulties, so he's not here at the minute. Like literally with us, nor in the game, so just a general heads up. Neil, it is your go.
I'd like to do my sneaky bow attack.
You by all means work away.
If that's all right with you.
It is.
All right. Sneaky bow.
That hits.
And then 9 damage.
9 damage. Nice. You pierce through the head. It's kind of jutting out of the head, and he's like, his head reels back, and he's like, still kicking though, still kicking, but he's not quite. He's on his last legs. He's gonna swing now at Tenchu. Nine
does not hit.
Cool. We're on Dakota.
I'm gonna
hit the bird.
I'm gonna take a massive risk. Koda, I swear to God.
I won't tell if you aim for the bird.
I'm gonna use my crossbow. I'm sorry, I'm gonna use my crossbow. So I'm gonna use the crossbow and shoot. And I'm gonna say, move out of my way, I have a really bad track record and I'm gonna shoot. Oh, yay.
You hit.
I'm gonna kind of like, oh, what, did you see that? Look, I hit it. 4 damage.
Alright, sinks into the chest, kind of goes like, falls backwards into the water. 1 second though. It does not resurrect.
Did you see that?
It floats by in the water, and there you go.
Good, catch it. We need its head.
Master Renan?
Yes.
If you please.
I hand Lady Nyla the machete.
This goes a bit mental to hack the head off of him. Darren, as a question. Yeah.
Yes.
Do these things have, hair at all attached to these to their zombie scalps?
So the scraggliest last bits of it, but yes, a little bit.
Like, essentially, I would like to loop the hair around belt loops and have them on.
Yeah, yeah, there'd be enough just to do that, yeah.
Just, like, I'm keeping an ear, you know, like, I know what it's like to have. Oh, Koda, that's so sweet. Like, it's very obvious that I have 2 heads higher from my hips, but if they fall, I'm gonna notice.
Yeah, exactly. No, you'll be fine.
Keep the hands from you. Yeah. So now we have 2 heads.
And we should probably jimmy the 2 surviving heads off these spikes.
Does anyone else have swords?
I have a sword.
What kind of sword?
I have a rapier.
Sharp?
Yeah. See, we can't. A rapier, you can't really pierce the head off. We need like a slashy sword.
Oh.
Sorry, I'm not trying to be a jerk about it. It's just that would make removing the head so much
easier. Yeah, no, that's a fair point. Yeah.
My machete is literally a saw.
Isadora, if you would like to take one of the heads off, and we can keep it all in the family, as it were.
Gladly! And she starts whacking off heads.
Nice. And we have four now.
How much did they say we were getting paid per head?
15.
I heard 50. Oh. I heard 50 for the job, but 15 per head.
15 per head, yes.
I heard it. Oh. But that's fine. That's still going to work out nice for us.
We're getting more for these bloody heads than for the job.
Yeah, you just go about hacking it, you know, sinew slicing. Nothing really shoots out because you know, got a lot of blood to pump through. But yeah, you go about doing it, and it takes a couple of minutes, but it's grand.
Oh, sorry, it's out of character. Apparently someone's Facebook sounds are coming through their audio.
Yeah, that was me, sorry.
Oh, okay.
It's Ian freaking out.
Damn it, Axel.
Rock's fault. Blame Ian! Character.
So, shall we continue on past the spiky spikes of death?
Spiky spikes.
I would like to, before we move on, just turn to... You see, I really aimed that time. Did you see? I really aimed.
Yes. I thought, why...
I...
Can you just keep...
Getting better.
Can you just keep moving? Can we just keep...
Yes.
Can you
yes.
just... Can you just yes. forget that it happened? Because I really would like
I
to.
I don't think I'm ever going to forget that.
Please, just for both of our sakes, please just forget.
Fine.
I'll be fine.
Gladly.
All right, Tenshu, lead the way.
Moving swiftly on from the awkward conversations, let's see what's down this way.
I'll follow Birdo.
Ah, Birdo.
Non-gender specific Birdo.
Bird person. Bird individual.
Looking down this long, treacherous hallway, you see what looks like another trap must have been set off. And, oh god, she's just laying it down the fucking yard, boy.
Ooh, hey!
Yeah, this wall here... this wall here has broken through from the other side.
It's quite fucked.
Like, okay. There's a lot of rocks where you are, there's a lot of zombie corpses under the rocks, they're not moving.
Can we get their heads?
But it's like if it pushed through. From that side.
Ah. That's more concerning.
From where you can get an extra two heads.
Lady Nyla, if you would like to do the honors?
Yes, we will continue to collect heads.
Do you want to just keep the machete until I need it?
Yes, I will throw it to you when...
How many heads are you wearing? Can you comfortably carry all those heads?
Well, I currently have three, and I believe Isadora has one. So perhaps yes. Isadora can, like, if you take the next, like, you can take the next two, then we both have three.
Yeah.
And we may spread them out, or put them in our bags, either, whatever, you know.
I think it's all good. It's a very good look for you, the heads on your belt. It's working.
Yeah, I'm pretty happy about it, too.
Alright, cool, yeah, you go about hacking off and removing the heads that you can, and you get an extra two.
Go ahead, Birdo.
Is this a passage through the wall, or is it just caved in rubble?
Oh, it's a passage. Would you like to go down or look into it, or...?
I'd like to look into it, definitely.
It looks, the more you look down into it, the more the stone starts to change. And if you want, give me an investigation check.
Okay, this is not going to be that great. That's a 9.
There's bits of blood and rotten flesh in the wall and claw marks at the wall, so you can kind of deduce that it most likely came, the zombies most likely came from this region.
Okay.
Hello, Rizbit. But yeah, so this seems to be their point of origin.
Okay.
Would they have been strong enough to break this wall, then?
I doubt it somehow.
No, I don't think these were zombies.
If you want to figure out how they did it, it'll require a higher dex, or not dex, investigation.
I'll do it.
I also want another look around.
That's a solid 11, Dazmataz.
Razzmatazzmatazzmataz? Is somebody else doing it?
Yeah, I'm doing it. I'm sorry.
Investigation.
I'm sorry. 10.
Rizbit!
Given the combined, someone, I guess, type a really brief recap for Ian from the brief stuff that he missed in Discord.
He's been watching. Apologies.
So with the combined effort, you kind of gather a little bit more information. From the scarring on the wall, it looks like a spell of some kind hit it. Intentional, an accident, you can't figure out. There's a lot of clawing and slapping against the wall. Like, there's like, you know, bits of flesh stuck to the wall and such. Like, if one of the zombies had been beating against the wall with its fist, and, like, essentially, since it's rotten skin, it was left behind when he pulled his fist back. So, it looks like, for whatever reason, they broke through the wall eventually. The spell most likely weakened a hell of a lot. It, like, cut a path through the wall, but it seems that this is how they came. They clawed their way through it. So what do you want to do?
Well, this seems like where they came from, right?
How much further does the passage where all of them go down? Because there may be some more directly nearby that, if given the opportunity to let them move around, it might be difficult for us to egress if we need to do it speedily. So perhaps we should secure this location before we enter into a brand new location that has been created that wasn't actually part of the job.
Not a bad idea.
Solid tactic, to be fair.
The alternative is that we try and block up part of this, but if we start blocking up water, we're going to create a dam, we create a problem. So I would suggest that perhaps Tenshu and Renan continue as we have been and scout ahead and just check it out.
I agree.
Yes,
of course.
Onwards then.
Can I have my machete back?
Yes, I toss off.
Please don't toss it at me. It doesn't work as a boomerang yet. That's not till level 3.
Before you is kind of a wide room with very there's actually a step up to get into this room. There's no water. There seems to be kind of a cabinet, like with a little grate on the front that seems to have like cleaning tools, or like, you know, if they needed to like unhook a grate of some kind, it, like, you know, to be basically that kind of basically just tools you would need to like for upkeep of the sewers. And there's a large map of the area with a like "you are here" dot and saying like, you know, sector B, that kind of thing. And that's all kind of located about this side here. Over here in the corner is, let me just drop it so it has a place on the map, this little X, is a slumped over individual, like kind of like if they lean against the wall and slowly start to, you know, drop, blood again smeared downwards as they dropped and fell, in jet black robes, clutching his, from what you can tell, the body isn't completely like, it's been there a few days, but there's like, dried blood on his neck. There's a like a chunk missing. He seems to be clutching his side, and a very large like knife wound or like a sword wound, a gash is across his stomach. Like his robes are ripped open, and he seems to be clutching that, and like he's got this really terrified like fear in his face that it's kind of like, oh shit, I'm gonna die, and that's basically what happens.
Do I recognize the clothes he's wearing as any kind of uniform or anything like that from the city?
In terms of the city, no, it's just jet black robes.
Okay, right. But there wouldn't be any faction that uses just jet black robes all the time.
No. It's right. Just, yeah, it's just black attire.
If something with swords did this, it was not Arizona. So something else is just blasting going through here. Perhaps.
Does he have anything on him? Like in his pockets?
Check his own.
In his pockets, you find some money, a total of 5 GP. And that's it. He seems to be sitting on a staff. Like, it seems to be kind of, like, down behind him. But it just seems to be made out of... It's just a regular quarter staff. It's just some really nice wood, essentially.
Anybody need a staff?
I mean, it would kind of be a monk weapon, but I don't really like using weapons.
I'll carry it. Or perhaps whoever's in the front should potentially carry it. Use it like a cane, but stick it out before us to kind of trigger traps before.
Pokey stick.
Essentially.
I take the pokey stick.
An anti-dying device.
An anti-dying device.
So, Dan.
Yes, Neil.
On the other side of the room, you were saying there was a map and some other stuff. What's going on there? Clean, like, maintenance.
Yeah, it's sewer maintenance. Like, a map of, like, where you are kind of thing. And, like, that.
So this guy doesn't just look like a sewer worker, does he?
But we don't know. Like, for all of this kind of the shit, like, the guards have given us this job, but the guards probably aren't the people who actually maintain the sewers. So this is a lot of this seems like, yeah, don't push. Are you poking it with a stick?
Yes.
Are you checking to see if it's trapped body?
Yes.
Okay. The body slumps forward, its jaw opens, and some cockroaches crawl out.
I immediately get sick.
Everyone roll con checks.
Even
make sure you guys don't start vomiting.
Even me.
I know you vomited, so you don't need to. But if they start vomiting, you have to.
Sorry. Oh no.
Oh.
Yeah, I think we're all vomiting.
Darren.
Hello. I don't know.
Darren.
Yeah.
In another way, my God. Like, is the god of death.
Yeah.
Like, fair enough, I'm not a religious person, I'm not around dead bodies all the time, but you, like, I am aware of death and the aftermath thereof. What I'm angling for here is advantage, but...
that's true, the body doesn't faze you, it's just...
The cockroach. One,
two, three.
Okay.
Yeah. No, it's three people simultaneously vomiting. I myself have a pretty solid iron stomach when it comes to a lot of things, but if three people started vomiting near me, I would start to gag.
I mean,
Rizbit and Esme just barely hit the mark. That user, like, he's kind of like, he's kind of heaving, and you keep it in, but everyone else is, yeah, you're vomiting.
I am so sorry.
Didn't think that would end that way, but it did. I'm so happy. I love the.
Are we so now? Does this count? Are we even? Because I was sorry. Now you're sorry.
You shot me in the back.
Yeah, but this
can
was
we
a very.
Can you
I
stop?
Really like this coat.
Coda. Can you stop bringing it up at every possible moment? Can we just forget it happened? Because I will slap you.
No, thank you.
Alright,
boys, that's enough. We need to keep moving.
He started it.
Before we move on,
he may be can, we use this,
can we use this map to reveal some of the nearby tunnels and maybe get alive?
I was thinking that we take it off the wall and bring it ourselves.
I
will get to Neil's question first, and then I'll get to that. Neil, you find some money. 5 GP, because it's even. Some parchment for, like, notes. It's kind of like more like logs, like, you know, Yeah, you know, when people have cleaned. But there is a spare key to get into the sewers underneath everything. Like, it, like when you kind of move the parchment, it's like there in front of you, and it's like, oh, a key, and it has like a little like a tag at the end of it. It's like spare, and then there's like a note beside it saying, "Don't lose it, Steve. I swear to God." Oh, I swear to God.
I just pocket it. I just keep it on me.
Cool. As for revealing glass, I'm gonna treat it as like a Resident Evil kind of thing. Picking up the map allows you to see the remainder of like the area. So you've got this.
Darren, if this has people playing.
A lot of stuff that I am drawing for it.
I appreciate.
Oh god, yeah. If anyone has a problem, I'll just tell them to get good. this area is an exit. It's marked as an exit, like, you know, exit B. Like, each sewer entrance has an exit and a... Or two exits, or entrances, whatever. You notice that this here... I just realized I'm struggling when I could ping it. This here isn't on the map.
Which?
Tunnel... Yeah, like, the tunnel basically is like a straight shot. And then there's, you know...
I see. Okay. Well, let's... Okay, so,
and obviously there's a tunnel over this side on the left that says it brings you to Junction A.
Is there any marking? You know that that pit that we found earlier. Is there any marking on the map to indicate where that goes, or if it's just a drainage?
It's marked as a drainage pit.
Okay.
So can I just like? I just want to stack all of the stuff that's already on that table onto, like, I assume there's a chair of some kind. Or even just jimmy open one of the lockers and put, like, what I'm imagining as lockers. I'm basically just putting it out of the way.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, you can do that.
Because, like, I want to move the body from across, like, on the floor and then put it on the table and then cover his face. It's like, yeah, bit of decency wouldn't.
Yeah, you can do that with he's quite a scrawny chap, so you don't really need a high strength. Like, even if you yourself couldn't.
He's also covered in vomit.
He's also covered in vomit. Even if you yourself couldn't, I'd imagine like someone else in the party would kind of be like, oh, here, let me help you. So like you don't need to roll, it happens. Yeah, so before you is a vomit covered man on a desk.
You just kind of like, I'm not going to bother cleaning up the vomit. What I would like is basically just. Kind of not like I don't know anything about preparing him for a funeral or anything, just kind of putting him into a decent position.
Yeah, no, you kind of like lie him out, like, you know, you cover his face to be respectful, and you kind of like lay his arms down by his side, and he's very just like, he's lying there, and he is indeed deceased.
Okay, right, guys, I'm going to suggest that we ensure that we have a clean shot to this entrance to the the eastern entrance to section B, and then we can go back and check out that other passage that's appeared that we have no map on.
Yeah,
that's fair.
Sounds good.
Yeah. All right.
So head up this corridor and see if it looks like a straight shot out.
Yeah, there's a straight shot out. You don't trigger any traps or anything. The ladder before you, it's grand, it's dry, there's no water in this area. This seems to be kind of more like the preferred entrance.
Fucking Phil.
Yeah, it's just a large room a relatively decent sized room with the ladder and stuff. And some, like, you know, sewer access, sector B, that kind of stuff, all labeled on that room.
Well then, that seems to be...
Yep. Let's head back to where the zombies came from.
Yeah. And be wary of anything with explore, because zombies don't actually have.
So I bring the torch in and have a gander.
Alright.
A gander.
As you begin to get closer to, like, this room here, like, the entrance to the room, it does get quite cold. Like, it's a sewer, yeah, so it's not exactly like, you know, Spain or anything, but like as you progress through, you're like, oh shit, it's pretty damn cold. And when you kind of get to like right here where you're kind of entering the room, it's just pretty, like you would describe it as, oh shit, it's cold, I need a jacket. And contrary to popular belief, not popular belief, but like despite the fact that it's freezing cold, but pretty damn cold, the room seems scorched, like there was a great fire at one point.
Trapped, perhaps?
No, not particularly. The room is, the stonework doesn't match the sewers. It's completely out of place. It kind of looks like it's almost like a cave to a degree. Oh shit, you can't see that number. I have the rooms numbered on my map. Where is the drop thing? There's a large desk in the middle that's been turned over, like been slapped down. You know, there's kind of like a... Oops, wrong thing. I can't even highlight them. Along these walls here, what looks would have been bookcases, a lot of them turned over, and there's like sleeping quarters here. And... in this corner here is a humanoid facing the wall. Yeah.
Oh no. If you Blair Witch me, I will kill you.
Yeah, actually.
Does this room have any entrances or exits, apart from the one we came through, obviously?
Nope, it is completely sealed. In like from what you can tell.
They're standing, yeah. Are they like underneath?
Yep, they're standing like neck or head slightly down, kinda looks like they're holding themselves. They're completely naked, bar like what looks like the rags of a loincloth / undergarments.
Is,
but other than that, they're completely naked.
Is this a human person, or is it?
It is a humanoid, yes. Okay. Scraggly hair, top, very pale skin.
I ready my bow behind the desk, and I'm kind of like, okay, we should whistle and see what happens.
I ready my greatsword.
I want to get out my gun.
I stay as far away from Coda as possible.
I move up and I sort of say, hello, are you okay?
Go away, Coda.
Shoot him again.
It's like I'll just draw him on the board. So
hush you.
That's cool.
Yeah, as you call, like it kind of like the humanoid turns around and looks at you. You see its eyes are glowing a really pale blue. It looks like some sort of fog is kind of emanating from its mouth and dropping down. It's kind of like a black mist. Its hair is frantic and it's clutching a blade. It's kind of like my arrow. It's a wait for the flavor. Gosh,
you know, I'm just telling you that it's happening.
It's okay. No, yeah, that's cool. We'll roll that up. It's clutching a sword like it's hugging a blade. The blade is stained with very dry blood. There's quite a lot of dry blood around its mouth. After, like, can you roll damage, I guess, Neil? I'm going to say, like, you got a really nice shot off.
Yes, sir.
It's cool.
Yay!
Nice.
Wow.
Please die. You look
it's kind of looking at you, like, shivering. It's absolutely, like, hyperventilating. The arrow just like slams into its shoulder. It doesn't even blink. Not that it can blink because it's got glowing eyes. But you know what I mean? It doesn't even phase the fact that you just shot it. And it kind of like looks around and it's hugging the sword like close to its chest. That's where its arms are. And like it removes one arm and puts it at the hilt. And you notice that the like blade is stuck to its skin from the cold.
Oh.
And like he kind of like jerks it down, ripping it and like pulling off a load of flesh from its skin and just lets out like a screech. Like, I'd imitate it, but there's people asleep in my house. He lets out, like, a colossal, just, like, ear-shattering, you know, and he just sprints straight at Esme.
I have a desk between me.
And everyone roll up, please.
Okay.
Yes!
For
yes,
sake, Renan.
What are you doing? Come on.
Oh, yay. Would I get an opportunity attack against him if he tried to run past me?
Technically, yes.
Sweet.
I'm going to allow this. Hold on, let me see. Oh, Esme, is that 22 for the...
That's initiative.
Okay, so it's actually you first.
Okay. I open with, we need fire, and then I shoot another arrow.
A fair assessment. Okay.
Esme.
The image before you was quite shocking. Yep.
That's cool. I'm frozen, you might say.
Well, get out.
Anyway, yeah, we need fire. Lots of it. ASAP. Also, I can't shoot right now. Someone else do something. Protect me. Can I jump behind the table?
You can, yeah. You can cower. That is a free action.
I believe it's called going into cover.
Eno, boy, you swing if you want.
I do.
Yeah, you do get an opportunity attack.
Nope.
Mine
roll? Oh, sorry.
Yeah, no, 16 hits.
Oh, sweet.
Cool. You caught into it, like, gashing it open, like, weird black pus and blood falls out and slaps across the ground. Again, this thing completely unscathed, and it's going to start hacking towards Neil. lol.
Oh, Jesus Christ, on a bike.
Oh, well, Esme, it was nice. We tried. Clark is on his way. He'll disappoint me. Actually, to be fair, she did a good job. So, who's he? Is he hitting me?
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, sweet Jesus.
Oh,
oh,
I'm unconscious.
Oh, wow. Slaanish has made a star.
Because I had 7. So I'm, like, significantly unconscious.
That's like... Go, Rizbit. It's your birthday. You gotta save her like it's your birthday.
It is now Isadora's go.
Chomps at the air. Literally Isadora, like, fire.
Don't have fire.
Oh, you ass.
Children, please.
Get out. Get out of the suit.
You're dead.
like I'm that gif of
Chris Traeger.
I really, really want to roll that suit.
I'm going to cast Vicious Mockery, which is a wisdom save, I think.
Okie dokie. It gets 2.
Cool.
What does Vicious Mockery do again? Like, as it me? To me, that is.
It does damage, and you have disadvantage on your... Doesn't do a lot of damage, but there you go.
I have disadvantage on my next attack, is it?
I will double check. I think it's just your natural in general, but I'll double check.
Okay, no, it's cool, because you cut out when you said what it was doing. Well, maybe it's just my...
Oh, sorry.
No, you can have it from your Maya.
Yeah. Alrighty, well, you're looking that up. Is that all you want to do, Amy?
Yeah, that's all I can do for the moment.
Cool, Rizbit.
Okay. So has he moved over toward Esme's?
Yeah.
Or did he just, like, shred the table?
Yeah, he kind of just started, like, he's right in front of the table, he kind of shredded through because it's a brittle little piece of shit.
Okay, so would I be able to get to Esme without provoking an attack of opportunity?
As long as you don't leave its zone of control, I think you're fine.
Yeah.
Yeah, you will be able to.
Grant. So I'm going to go over to Esme. Just stand here, just do it. And heal him for her for 5 health.
Ooh,
nice.
And that's my heals gone.
That put me at 0.
I have some.
Oh no, it'll break, like, it gets you to 0 and then you go up to 5.
Oh, how handy.
So are you, is Is Esme back in the fight, like?
Yeah.
Deadly, that's awesome.
What are you
talking about? Lay on hands,
I'm assuming.
Lay on hands. Yeah, sorry, I should have said lay on hands.
Tenshu, how about you, buddy?
How about me? I think I'm going to start hitting it. Because that seems to work pretty well so far. So that's a 22 to hit.
Yeah, you slap and slap.
Kick her in the balls.
That's 7 damage, and I'm going to bonus action attack again.
Fantastic.
21 to hit.
Nice.
Yes.
And 6 damage, so a total of 13.
Deadly, deadly. You punch and slap, bits of flesh fall, and you kind of punch at one point and the flesh kind of wraps around your hand. It's that, like, saggy. But it's, like, bits of it have fallen off. It's really on its last legs, but it's still kicking. Renan, it is your go.
Okay. I am going to... Can I get up on the desk?
It's flipped over. Like, in a defensive position, if you know what I mean. Like, if you were getting shot at, that kind of, like, cowboy style thing.
Okay, well, I will just go up to this crazy bitch and smack it with my machete. 16
to hit. 16, yes, 16 hits.
I'm dual wielding or two handing, so I will roll shit damage. That's a 3.
Well, it's okay.
Oh, good.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah, yeah, you see, you kind of like bring it down and be heavy, and it kind of like looks as it's coming down and kind of like it knows. You kind of like crash down into it. And again, kind of previously between its neck and its shoulder, you just cleave down and half of it just falls over. It start like, well, the bits of it that are on the ground start to like trash about and just crumble to ash.
And I immediately get sick again.
Right there with you, buddy.
Yeah, the room is still shockingly cold. When it, as it dies, it kind of lets out a burst of cold. Not enough to damage you, but kind of be like, but yeah.
Oh, look, vomit sickles.
It freezes as you vomit.
Can I use that as a projectile weapon?
No. I'll fire them like arrows.
So yeah, congratulations, guys, for defeating such an enemy. You gain a level.
Ooh, we're level 2.
Yeah.
Also, yes,
what the
actually.
Hell are you?
Yeah. What is it
for chat? We are doing milestone levels rather than XP. It's actually just that little thing I dreamt up myself. It's kind of like a mixture of a zombie and a skeleton. It doesn't really have a name. Its flavor text is taken from an enemy in a Dark Souls 3 natural.
Sure.
Oh yeah, I expect a hell of a lot of that. If anyone's out there,
I already told chat that there's Dark Souls shit in it.
But yeah, it's more just like there's an enemy and it clutches their sword. It looks like they're hugging it, and it just looks. I was like, I need to put them into my game. They're so just like cool. But yeah, so it's just kind of like think of it like a skeleton hybrid or skeleton zombie hybrid, but without the reanimation factor, because I still think that's shitty. But yeah, GG. So yeah, milestone levels for anyone confused as to why people just got a level. But yeah, anyway, yes, it crumbles, it's cold, there's a hacked up desk and a no longer unconscious Esme, and you're in a room full of burnt out books. Not all, obviously, but you know, a burnt out kind of layery room thing.
Is the head is gone?
Yes, yes, it completely like crumbled and was like...
Is the sword still there?
The sword is gone.
Oh, good.
Oh.
Can...
Well, all of the... Well, passing over that absolute sheer nonsense.
I'm going to roll investigation to see if I can find if there was a way out of the...
You cut off there, Amy.
Sorry, I'm going to roll investigation to see if there I can find another way out of this room.
Okay.
Oh.
Nice.
That's nice. Okay, there is no... Like, no immediate, like, exit. Over here, the stone looks odd to the sense
somewhere
that,
where?
Like, the thing, over at the north side, sorry. Of the
oh, where it was standing.
Was actually standing. Yeah, where it was standing. It's kind of, like, think of it like in Fullmetal Alchemist, where if a wall's been modified too many times, it has those
you
flicks.
Can see, yeah.
Yeah, it looks like whoever lived here used to, like, you know, either use a spell that, like, manipulated stone or something to that effect. So they could, like, you know, there was no actual doorway, it's just... And it kind of, like, reaches to the ceiling, so you kind of deduce that maybe it wasn't a door, it was more stairs. So, like, that's how they would have came and gone from this area, because, like, you can kind of guess that this over here, the blown-out wall, definitely wasn't the intended entrance or anything.
I tell the others anyway.
Cool, cool.
So we know that it's definitely stairs, or we just know that it's disturbed wall?
It's disturbed wall, but the markings kind of raised to the roof.
That it was stairs.
So you kind of like, perhaps it was stairs, because they kind of raise up to the roof.
Is there a bouton? Can we press a bouton?
There's no boutons.
I'm pretty sure there isn't much left, Rana. Rana.
May I take a look at the body?
Yeah. It's more a pile of ashes and guts, but...
Thank you, small friend.
I just sort of, like, take out my great sword and just sort of poke it around to see if there's anything.
That's fair.
What loot does the corpse have?
The loot, the corpse itself contains nothing. It's literally just ash. Like, when you put your sword through it, there's, like, bits of, like, chunks of flesh that didn't fully dissolve.
Yeah.
But it itself is just, whatever it is now dead.
Fair enough.
You were saying that there was a lot, like, that there was bookshelves around?
Like, bookshelves and, like, you know, the drawers and the desks are still intact, that sort of thing.
Have the bookshelves been, like, burned
a hell of a lot of them have a lot of them have been burned out. There is, like, the odd tome that you can, like, the contents are most likely burned out, but you can kind of make out the spine.
Just seeing if you can get any, like, oral masturbation or whatever, try and get a sense of what's going on, like, in this room. Okay. I would also suggest someone try and get into that, like, does someone have high... Is someone particularly intelligent?
I am pretty intelligent, yeah.
Yeah, I might suggest that you guys have a look at the books, and then I might go and have a look at the table, in case those are locked. I've been known to have a bit of a talent for opening those kind of things.
We'll take a bookshelf each or something.
I would like to investigate the bookshelf that is furthest from Coda's bookshelf, please.
This is excellent. Yes, by all means, roll away, friends, roll away.
Solid 10.
12.
From scanning over both shelves, like, kind of thoroughly, like, well, you know, picking out what could potentially be still intact, you kind of figure out that, like, well, the ones you're holding, but not all of them, seem to revolve around the body and what happens after death, and there's what looks like kind of a spell book or something at one point, but it's so badly singed that, like, or like destroyed by fire, but, like, you can kind of see, like, for a few pages it's like a paragraph of, like, a spell, and you're like, well, deduce, like, what spell would have been. But you kind of see the rhyming of the words and the placement and stuff that you find. Like, this is most likely something would have been magical to a degree, or a chant or a ritual.
Mm. Well, that's nice. Necromancy. It's not illegal here, probably. This mad world where people can do what they like.
Yeah.
Call the boss. Terry.
Mom. Anyway.
So, D-Man,
yeah.
I would like to have a wee look at the drawers of the desk, see if anything is salvageable, any information, notes, whatever.
Are you sure? You roly roly.
Investigation, is it?
Yeah.
Ew. God damn it, Esme. Can it be that I struggle with a lock? I just refuse to believe it's locked. Is that what it is?
Yes. For the sake of the fact that, like, that's such a fucking pitiful role. Yes, that's exactly what it is.
It's stuck.
Kind of like trying to pull it over. Like, hey guys, is this kind of locked? And like the nearest person kind of comes over and just like pulls it open. It's like, no, not in the slightest, Esme.
Guys, I just came back from being slightly dead. And someone else have a look at these things. Like, very
good save, Neil. Good save.
This guy sits down in a corner for a while. Whoever is outlining that, fuck you. White devil.
20.
Okay, what you find is the following. 15 gold pieces, a potion of healing, a spell scroll of light, and a journal.
Shiny, most shiny.
So yeah, that's the contents of the drawer. As for the potion of healing, it's just like a flat potion of healing. It's not a lesser or a greater, it's just a potion of healing.
Can I read the journal, please?
There is indeed text. What do you speak and read and write?
I speak Common, Elven, Infernal, and Orc.
You do not understand what it says.
Oh.
I can add Arakokran and Auron to that.
What a lovely story.
No dice.
I can add Goblin.
No dice.
Anybody speak Undercommon?
Nope.
No.
No dice.
Well, have to get it looked at in the city then, won't we?
Might get some more reward for it from the gods.
Possibly.
I don't think we should give the journal to the guards.
I'm definitely planning on not giving giving them that extra key that we found.
That's fine. Then
probably keep that.
It would be nice
come back down here
to have a way to get back down here if something else goes awry.
It's also a good place to hide during dragon attacks.
That is true, we have proved that.
Bunker buddies.
So, just to summate the adventure so far, or to summate the things we are leaving this place with, we have 6 zombie heads. Yes.
Correct.
Yep.
6 zombie heads. So we have the map, but the map isn't all that useful. We found multiple instances of 5 gold pieces. 1, 2, and then 15. Yeah, so total 25 gold pieces. Then the potion, the scroll, and the journal. And a key.
Correct, yes.
Just making sure.
Yep. That's cool.
Oh, and the medallion of Torok, which is definitely not great.
The opposite of banter.
And not the opposite of banter, just generally not great.
But it's shiny.
Have we dealt with this problem now? Is it time to leave?
Based on the fact that that thing nearly killed me, and it was in a wall that should not be here, I do not for a second believe this is the end of this situation. But I believe we finished it. Oh yes, I remember we have seen that. At the very least, let us go outside, hope that we are not going to get burned alive or different dragon attacked alive by dragons, and go to the cop. Give them our zombie heads, collect our gold, split it evenly, and then be on our way.
I thought you said that thing was a fake wall over there. Are we ignoring that problem?
Well, it's not like we know it was made with magic, but it's not like we have any access to it.
Oh, I just don't really understand when you talk about these things. Alright.
Well, we can report to the guards.
What should we?
Well, then it'll be their problem.
So long as they don't ask us questions about it.
It's not like we can answer questions about it, we just found it.
Let us depart. I would like to not be down here and almost dead.
Agreed. Agreed.
Alright, so he's leaving?
Yeah.
Cool. Alright, it
Southeast entrance. Let me come up somewhere.
Which exit are you taking, Lex? Oh.
This one?
I'd run for the road, safer travel.
The one, oh yeah, the one you stir, okay. As you go, as you climb it up, you notice that there's blood on this. Dried blood.
On the ladder.
Yeah, I was going to make you roll, but then I realized if you're like scurrying to get out, you'd see it because you're looking where your hands are going. So yes, there is dried blood on the ladder.
Lovely.
You never saw the rest of those rats, either. Those little ones. I wonder where they got to. Mm-hmm.
Probably found a hole to hide in somewhere.
Wow.
But yeah, you just climb, and the door is locked. And again, there's a little bit of blood near the handle. But you put your key in, be it the one Phil gave you or the spare, and it turns and unlocks, and you return to the outside world. Okay. Well, I'm going to flick the screen back over to the map because it's so goddamn pretty. Whoop-wooka. Oh, wait, hold on. I should probably leave this city since it's, you know, we're in the city. Yeah, you come out, immediately, it's a hell of a lot darker than you went in. It's getting close to evening time now. Crowds are kind of rushing about, nothing serious. The place isn't on fire, first and foremost, I suppose I should say. there's no hellfire, there's no screaming, there's a lot of commotion, but there's no screaming. When you kind of leave the alley, you kind of look up, and kind of around here, like that kind of area of the wall, there's a very tall pillar of smoke rising from the top of the wall. But where, other than that, this wall here, the very front of...
Where are we now?
Oh, you're about...
Alright.
Quite close to the HQ of the guards, if that's where your next destination is.
So there's people rushing about, but are they panicking?
More just concerned, but no, there's no like, oh my god! But it's more a case of just like, whoa, That was a shit show we were involved with, eh?
My cabbages!
Yeah, exactly.
Can I stop the nearest person and ask what's going on?
Yeah, as you kind of, like, emerge from the alleyway, you kind of, like, put your arm out and, like, a rushing woman is kind of like, What? Did you not see the dragon? We're trying to get, like, you know... Indoors. They say they shot it down, but I don't trust those dragons.
What colour was it?
I don't know. They don't tell us anything. The guards told us to get indoors and stop asking questions.
So you didn't actually see a dragon?
You heard the horn. That's what it means. Dragons. Why would the horns lie?
Oh my
Why
God.
Indeed.
Say that again. Yeah, I didn't hear you.
It's reminding me of something else and I'm really happy.
Well, should we get indoors or should we investigate?
We should get indoors in the guard area and ask.
Yeah, if we go back to the city watch, they'll know what's happening.
Ideally. Not realistically, but ideally.
Well, we hope.
There's right. That whole thing of there shouldn't be criminals in the underground, but there are. You know, that whole.
Well, yeah, that's kind of like the basis of a criminal is going where you're not meant to.
You'd know all about that, wouldn't you, Lady Nyla?
It could be avoided. That whole having a trap. Ooh, Darren.
Yes.
Upon like further inspection of the map in the light of day, does it indicate where there are traps so that people who are working there won't trigger them?
Yes, there are very, very minuscule green dots of where all the traps would have been.
We need more maps.
Yeah, glancing over them, you'd kind of be like, all right, whatever. But then, you kind of looking at a property, you kind of be like, oh, wait, that's... Okay, yeah, so like a green dot indicate the trap.
Oh, shit, we have that little box as well. The box.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Even the DM forgot about the box.
The box.
Darren.
Oh God, there's a head in there, isn't there?
We're out in the streets now, right? Yeah.
You are indeed.
Can I pull on my cloak and hat and all that I got off the scarecrow?
You can indeed.
I'm sorry. The what? The warehouse?
The gothic trinkets. Coda helped a really weird old lady fix her wagon on his travels to the city, and she gifted him with a bag full of scarecrow clothes.
Wink,
was there a casket? Was her mother in there?
Oh god.
She's concerned.
So yeah, Coda's wrapping up in cloaks and hats and trying to hide himself as much as possible.
That's fair, you do that. Grand. No issue.
I just pull up my hood and like, right, let's go. City watch.
So you return to Sheriff Harkin.
Get on money and get out of here.
Cool. As you expect, when you approaching there, it's just chaos. It's mainly people aren't really trying to use the city, go in there, and they're more just yelling at all the guards outside, what is it? And they're just kind of whoa, calm down. And quite a burly dwarf kind of stops you before you go in the door. The door, and he's like, whoa, state your business. It's kind of a bit of a clusterfuck at the minute.
I just held up the zombie heads, we did the sewer job. We need to get inside.
Oh, you're the sewer rats. Okay, let's go. And he's like, go on in, Harkin will try find time for you, I guess.
I was almost killed. I just keep walking away. I always knew there was a reason to hate dwarves. Now I remember one.
Okay, when you're shoot in, as you can expect, again, the place is just in chaos. People are running around yelling at each other, generic secretary characters running around with the pile of paperwork, oh god.
Yeah.
Harkin sees you enter and he's gestures into his office really irritatingly, come on. And he closes the door when you come in and he's like, oh yeah, the sewer rats. Well, what did you just do?
How's work?
What happened to the city?
Oh, he's like, the fucking dragons. We don't know where they came. One of them, there was two apparently, but one turned off. Maybe you got cold feet? I don't know. Don't particularly care.
Was anything
our scouts damaged? Indicated it came. Yeah, several of the warforged up top. They didn't fire for some reason. So the dragons got a hell of a lot closer than they fucking should have. So we're looking into that.
Nowhere else in the city was hit.
No, they damaged the wall and some of the guardians, but the bodies lying outside, which is also a gigantic clusterfuck. And the paperwork, oh my god. And he slumps down into his chair and he's like, oh, why did I do this job?
That's great.
He's like, yeah.
That's me. Hold on, that's me.
can we have our payment now for doing your sewer job?
We have 6 zombie heads. And we have proof of the fact that we've cleared this situation out because we have 6 zombie heads.
There was also something much worse than a zombie down there.
Coda.
Yeah.
He kind of perks up and he's like, you have you guys seen Pacific Rim? Or the, at least the gift set where Idris Elba is like, you, stop talking. You, keep talking. he does that respectively. He points at Renan and Esme, and he's like, shut up, what?
I want to look around at the others and see what sort of looks they're giving me.
Just tell them. Just tell them.
Sneers. They don't have to roll or tell me. It's sneers, I know it is.
I don't know what it was.
Well, whatever it was, it's dead now.
It's dead.
Okay. There's something down there. What is it? I don't know what it was. That is...
There was something down there. What matters now is that it's dead, and you owe us money for killing it.
Oh, fucking hard to go, these ones. He's fine, and he walks out of the room.
Just putting it out there, you're probably going to need to give us a little bit more money. We were told about zombies, not about, more powerful zombies. And I nearly died, so hazard pay would indicate that we at least get, maybe another 50, 20 gold on top of what we're getting already. Healing spells don't come cheap and all that.
He, like, you're saying this as he's, like, moving around the office to go to the door, and he opens the door, and it kind of, like, blocks your view of him, and he leans over, and he's like, I'll think about it, and he walks out of the room and closes the door after him.
Did he just walk away without paying us?
He said he'd be back in a minute. When you mentioned money, he was like, fine, and got up.
That's nice. We should probably tell him that the maintenance guy is dead.
Yeah, that would be
I thought you were all giving filthy looks when I tried to mention anything.
I told you to say stuff, but look, we'll ignore that. They can go and investigate. What's the worst that could happen?
As you say, they walks back in and he's like, well, we could all die. He has a bag with him, like, a very large coin purse. Ooh. And he's like, right, front and center, put the heads.
We put the heads on his desk.
Yeah, we unhook our zombie heads and just place them before him. All staring.
He kind of gives them a look over and he's like, He pokes one of them. And he's like, oh, wow, they're not illusions. That's a first. Six heads, and he's like, 50 for the job. Counts it out in his head. Literally don't know the math at the current time. 140, right. He's like, right,
that's it.
It's why I draw. He puts the bag, and he's like, that's 140, and he looks over at Esme, and he's like, looks at you really, like, just unimpressed, and he rolls his eye, and he's like, and an extra 15 for the wounded.
Oh, that's nice. Me! I get money.
Yes.
Why do you get money?
I believe we're going to just divvy it all out equally.
Because I got wounded, so I need money.
How did you get wounded?
I got shot in the back.
Zombies that can shoot. Fucking excellent.
And
he has a big burlap sack and he starts throwing the heads into him.
Nobody say a word.
He goes over to a ward and he writes gun wielding zombies on it. Questionnaire.
walks
back to his desk and he's like, right, he's like, are all of you natives here?
No.
Like, do you live here?
Yes.
Well, I don't mean to be the bearer of bad news, but you probably won't be going anywhere anytime soon.
That's fine.
Why? The
city's not
going.
No one comes in, no one goes out.
What?
Why?
Because of this dragon.
What?
Because of the dragon.
Yeah, if Ford, constructs that are literally programmed, they're very being to shoot dragons, don't fire. Someone fucked with them, and I'm going to find out who. So until that's sorted, no one walks outside this bloody place.
Surely there's some routes for people who have urgent business and need to leave.
They can urgently kiss my ass. Now, I'm fairly sure your medical pay and your... A job well done, which is fair. As irritated as I come across, I apologize. You did a great job. Fair play. But realistically, that's not my issue. If you're stuck, go... The slums have incredibly cheap inns. There's a few inns around town that don't charge you that much per night. I'm sure a few nights here won't kill you. And he's like, and who knows? If you're looking for work, come back. I'll probably have something. There's always something going on in this bloody town. City, I mean.
Yeah, sounds about right.
There's no way out.
Very fine.
Bollocks.
Can I ask a question?
Out of character or to Harkin?
No, I'm good. Yeah, to Harkin. It's out of character. His name is Harkin, yeah?
Yes, Harkin.
I just need to make a note of that. So there's a dead maintenance worker down there.
Wait. Maintenance where? The sewers?
Yeah.
You don't post maintenance workers. They just go down when they have to clean. No one's gone down there since the supposed attack.
There's a dead maintenance worker down there?
All I'm wearing.
There's a dead man in black robes.
Yeah, there's a man in black robes. And he is on a table. He is mildly covered in vomit at the same time. But just as if you got a clean up crew or whatever, you just kinda didn't want to carry around a dead body, it generally doesn't look well.
Like that, I'm not. He is testing me. Okay, that's fair. Thank you for not traipsing a corpse through town. That's the last thing I need. I will dispatch people to investigate now that our valiant heroes have cleared the sewers.
Thank you. That was nice.
But to be fair, he kind of leans, like he's sitting in his desk at this point, really, like, leans in very seriously. He's like, gun-wielding zombies, or crossbow-wielding zombies, people that shouldn't belong on Earth, that's kind of a lot of red flags for one thing, like the outbreak now that...
Mate, do you want a red flag? Potential smugglers down there too. Oh my god.
And torturers.
Oh yeah, torturers and rats. Oh my god, the rats.
Don't
he's just like
rats,
he's like looking at
some
you
sort
some
of frost
like
monster.
Some like wide eyed
yeah,
somewhat wide eyed and nodding. As you're explaining this, like he's looking at you quite wide eyed, nodding, just like yeah. He's like not blinking, not breaking eye contact, but his hands are just reaching into a desk and he like pulls out a bottle and he's like, Yeah. Starts pouring himself and he's like, yeah.
Like, Harkin, I'm not going to kid you. There's probably a lot going on down there. A lot of things you're going to have to deal with. So I would suggest you outsource that work to people. Like, potentially us, because it's always nice to have jobs. But, like, we can't do anything with what's down there. So perhaps the actual police can go. And then if there's anything you want us to follow up on, I'm sure you'll find us around.
He looks at you and he's like about to take a drink. And he's like, you know, like, oh, what makes you say smugglers anyway? Because that's quite the accusation in this place.
The black mask.
Like, mid drink, he kind of pauses and he's like, okay. Thank you for your reports. They will be filed accordingly. If you do want those jobs, when they pop up. Let me know where I can find you and we will continue this investigation together.
Any chance doing these jobs will in his passage out of the city?
He's like, sorry. Even I don't get passage out of this bloody shithole.
Oh my god.
But then again, it's my shithole, so, you know. Whatever. Takes, like, knocks the rest of the drink back and he's like, right. Stands up and he's like, you got your money. You got your money. He actually, in my head, he has white hair. Like, not old hair. He's kind of like a stocky young man.
I'd like to Misty step out doing the Batman thing where it's like not finished talking, but now he's not here.
Oh my god, he'll have like a rat signal for this guy.
Like, yeah, there is this.
He kind of hears that and he's like, you won't last very long in the skies, my friend, but it's you can work, it's worth a try. But he's like, yeah, right, so that's a lot of information and accusations. We will want to ask you, like, well, yeah, but like,
no, I appreciate it. I'm sorry.
Yeah, no, that's, yeah, no, I can see where you're coming from. We will probably want to like interview you properly and get it on. And he's like, air quotes, record. Don't be a stranger. I'll probably like either you find me or I'll find you. Like, it's going to be what's going to happen either way. So for the time being, the dragon's dead. No matter what all the screaming people outside say, it's not moving. So I wouldn't worry about it.
Yeah. Sounds like a plan.
What plan? We have a plan?
Yeah, we're going to go to the park. Let's go.
Pleasure to work with you, Sheriff.
Yeah, we'll see you soon.
Pleasure. Kind of like nods.
Alright. Let's go spend our winnings.
Wow, I was like, wow, my house smells like burnt dog food. And I'm just after hearing someone scream like, the cocker! And I'm like, oh, should I help? I'm going to die the way I live, playing D&D. But yes. Yous are kind of like led out back into the main area, you know, when you walk into a precinct kind of thing. And the secretary is kind of like, do you need any assistance? Or is that all you need? Or...
Can you direct us to literally the nearest place that we can all get baths?
She stands up and she's like, she walks over to a press and takes out a leaflet. And she's like, here you go, and hands you a leaflet. It's like a very fancy spa and inn combination thing. It's very pricey. And it's called the Knife Ear Inn.
Oh, that's mean.
I don't know what that means.
It's an insult
to
elves.
It's a slur for elves in Dragon Age.
It's a slur, isn't it?
Yeah.
I couldn't remember if it was a backhand comment kind of thing, but it's a slur. Okay, I'll probably change that. It's called the Pretty Elves Inn for the time being. Yeah, because it's like, it's just more a case of like calling a dwarf short, but I was like, wait, no, it's actually more, yeah, not yet. But it's a Pretty Elves Inn for the time being.
Let's I'll come up with better. Go, lads.
Because my notes have group legs. I opened my book and I was like, oh, they're all gone. Yes, so the Pretty Elf.
Does.
Yes.
I really, really have to pee, and I'm also at half nine tomorrow.
That's cool. Yeah, it's 12:10. I was kind of like, you know, like, you guys get to the inn and book a room, and it's, you know, we'll work out the price some other time. It's not important to me. Yeah, you guys get a bath, you have a nice evening, etc., etc. There's still a bit of unrest in the air, but you guys know that Dragon is dead. So is that cool? We'll leave it there. Is that cool? Any last minute questions, comments?
Can we roll help or leveling up?
Yeah. Everyone roll help.
It's a roll a hit die.
Yes, roll a hit die. Plus your con if you have a con.
Good job.
I'll take that. Solid four.
Damn, rolling
also
below
for,
average.
For reference, that's where the inn is in this kind of like section here.
Cool.
Okay.
Where's my character? I love how I always have a plus
one. I don't wanna look.
I love that the fighters roll.
Yes!
Oh, wow,
well done!
Nice! Well done. Excellent roll.
Alright, Esme. Let's not disappoint.
Tank and spank.
I'm on
50. Yeah! That's solid, man. You can't complain there, jeez.
You did it.
Nice. Well done. Ooh, nice, 22. Nice. Cool. Sure, we'll leave it there then, guys. For everyone who watched and tuned in, thank you. We'll be doing this again next Wednesday at 9.
Thank you so much for tuning in. Same bat channel.
We'll try to fix some of the things that you guys commented on in the chat. That was all very helpful. Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks for your feedback.
Yeah,
guys.
Thank you, guys. Yeah. Thanks for watching.
Thanks, everyone.
Great. Much
cool. Thanks, guys.
Good night, friendos.
Okay, good night.